Talking Fashion, the weekly broadcast featuring community leaders who know and understand the power of dressing for success. Join Robert Ford and friends as they build a legacy of productive men through character, leadership, and fashion. So are you ready to empower?
I can't hear you.
Ready to make a difference?
Come on, I can feel it.
Ready to change lives?
Can you feel it?
Join Robert Ford and friends. It's genuine, authentic, candid talk. Just keeping it real. Can you feel it? Live from the King Edward in downtown Jackson. Welcome to Talking Fashion with your host, Robert Ford.
Hey guys, thank you for tuning in. Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and friends. Guys, we got a great show for you today. It's going to be really great because we are representing the Kentucky Derby style. And this young man, all the way from the Caribbean, man, he got one of the best restaurants in Jackson, Mississippi. The food is off the chains, man. I'm so honored to have him on my show. Check it out now. Check it out. Mr. Godfrey Morgan. Okay, he's sitting there. He's sitting there waiting to come on the show. But let me tell you, man, the restaurant is unbelievable. The food is unbelievable. At this time, I want to introduce my friend. Because you know why? This man would do things behind the scene that other people won't do. He'll write a check when it's necessary. So at this time, we got a little Caribbean music going for him. Can you be my cheerleader? Let me introduce you to my friend, Mr. Godfrey Morgan. Come on stage, baby. Come on stage, big dog. Come on, what you got? What you got? How you doing, my friend? Give me some love, baby. Give me some love. Man, what you doing, man, in our community is awesome. We're going to let that music play a little bit. We're going to break it down. Show me a little Caribbean style from the island, baby. What island are you from? Jamaica. From Jamaica. So crank that thing up a little bit, Larry. Yeah, how you guys do it over there, man? Let's get this show going. Wow. Mr. Godfrey Morgan.
Yes.
On the talk show set with Robert Ford. Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and friends.
Robert Ford and friends.
Can I keep it real?
Yes.
I want you to keep it real today.
Yes.
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Thank you.
What's going on, man? Tell me about you first. We'll get into the restaurant later. Tell me, man, I love that outfit. We going to the Kentucky Derby, baby.
Yes.
You know, we might be on the black there, but it's okay. No, you're looking sharp, man. Tell me about you first. Mm-hmm. Tell me about that outfit.
Well, I was looking through my closet. I'm like, okay, what can I represent today? And I said, why not just do me,
you know? Whoa. Say that again. Say that again. Send that camera right there.
Why not just do me?
And that's what our young people need to understand.
You know?
Do you in a very professional way.
Yes.
That looks sharp. Go ahead. Tell me a little bit about who you are, where you're from. Tell our audience, man, why come to America? Why come to America? Eddie Murphy and Arsenio Hall coming to America. Are you looking for your queen?
Oh my God.
Sorry, go ahead. Let me slow down.
Well, just a little Jamaican boy.
Hey, you at home, loosen up, you at home, loosen up, shake that thing out, shake it out, man, do the burning, I'm sorry, guys, go ahead.
Well, as I said before, I'm from Jamaica, you know, work in the hotel industry there, and did want to basically make a difference, grow, be a little bit more, and I guess the United States is the land of opportunity. So went to culinary school here, Hines Community College. From there, start to work for Louis Bruno,
Okay.
That's when
okay.
I have Bruno's restaurant.
Yeah.
And then also working for Bravo's.
Mm-hmm. Bravo's. Yeah.
So.
Is that Jeff Goodman?
Jeff Good and
Dan
Jeff
Good.
Yes. So I was night shift for Louis, day shift at Bruno's, and in between that, going to school at the same time.
Let me ask you a question.
Yes.
At Bruno's, did they let you put your own touch, your own flavor, your own style on the menu, or you just had to go by what they gave you and cook what they tell you to cook? Or did you do your own little, you know, personal touch?
I put my little personal touch this on it. As one thing I love about Louis Bruno, when I started there, I started making salads. Mm-hmm. And then
Wait a minute, hold on. Making what?
Salads?
Oh, they had you on a salad line. Oh, Lord Jesus.
You got to start from somewhere.
Salad? Go to this man's restaurant, man. I don't want no salad. Well, his salad is off the chain. Yeah. It's really good. But you bring it on, brother. You got them, oxtails.
Yes.
You got
jerk chicken.
Man, we'll get in there. We'll get in there. We'll get in there because I'm getting hungry, baby. I'm getting around, my studio right behind my, my dressing room right behind here. I know you left me a plate, but no, we'll get in there. Go ahead.
And then one day he had some fish leave back in the fridge and he wanted to create a special. Mm-hmm. And I asked him, could I do it for him? And it was some snapper fillet, mm-hmm. Stuff it with vegetable, make a nice butter sauce, put over it and roasted it. And serve it with a garlic curry sauce. Mm. And it sold off. It sold out. A special sold out.
Uh-oh, this is promotion time.
Yes.
This is promotion coming. I feel it. I see it coming. Promotion time. Go ahead, brother. Go ahead.
And from that, I've been start coming up to it, the daily specials at the restaurant. And
you had to come up with the daily special.
I come up with the daily special. It was a
Well, God do it or what? Just from a salad, man, just give me an old salad. Just give me a Caesar salad. Now you got your own special. You're coming up with the specials.
Yes. You'd have to start from somewhere. And I did not mind making salads if this were me to go to.
Right.
And that lead from there, I realized to say, you know what? I need some more money in my pocket.
Come on.
I didn't have a vehicle at that time. Just got here in America. Didn't have a vehicle, so...
Oh, you didn't have your visa?
No, I didn't have a vehicle. I didn't have a car.
You didn't have a car.
It's the accent.
Yeah, it's the accent. Hey, man. Hey, Jamaica, man. Now, what's going on? I ain't going to go there. Let's keep it rolling.
So I got a day job with Jeff Good at Bravo's, mm-hmm. Cooking pasta at the pasta station.
Now you went from salad to pasta. Mm-hmm. Okay, you're moving up the ladder, baby. We're moving up. We're going to get some meat in there or something. It's pretty soon here. Go ahead.
And I worked both of those jobs, going to school, saved my money. I bought my first vehicle, 1997 Georgia Chevy. I call it kidnap van here.
You call it what?
We call it the kidnap van. You know those
kidnap
old, you know those old
yeah,
Chevy old van? Old,
yeah.
I was hopping down Northside Drive in that van.
Wow.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And
now you're on a car lot. Mm-hmm. No, I'm just
Then I started a little catering, selling food out of the back of the van.
What?
To different offices downtown.
Yeah, you better get this. You better get this here. Start making salad to the pasta. Now you got to bottom of a 1919 van and he's selling food out the van. That is, man, what I'm going to let him tell you. Young people, it's no excuse.
Not at all. Not
Godfrey, it's no excuse. You came from Jamaica.
Yes.
Across the, I think that's Atlantic Ocean. No, the Gulf of Mexico. One of them oceans you came across to come to America.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. To find your queen, your pasta. Okay, go ahead.
I love it. I love it. Yes. I start to sell plate downtown. I go to different offices and introduce myself and just tell them what I do and let them bring the food for them to try. And next thing you know, every time I have a day off, my one day off I have, I'm selling plates out of the back of the 1977 Georgia Chevy van.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. And shortly after then, Jeff Good offered me an opportunity to have a spot available downtown that he wasn't using, he was leasing. And said, I got a lot of talent, I would be great to open up something there. And I put a menu together, meat pie, jerk chicken, po' boy, creating some type of special of the day. And it worked out really well. The restaurant was open about for a year, but I was young. It was a lot of pressure hitting. Didn't know to anchor business with the high, the low, the in between.
Right. And
I ended up closing the restaurant and moving to Tunica, Mississippi.
What?
Yep, to work at
closing Memphis, Tennessee. Tunica, well, we got the Tuna casinos up there, all that stuff. You're working for the casinos now.
I was working for the Grand Casino.
As a
sous chef there.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This is a journey then. This is a whole journey coming from Jamaica, going across the ocean, coming to Jackson, Mississippi, working for Jeff Good, and starting off in the pasta, salad, then pasta, then working at the van. Now you're going, you open your own business, didn't work out, and going to Tunica, Mississippi.
Tunica, Mississippi. Mm-hmm. Small town, Tunica, Mississippi. Working as a sous chef there. I was doing very well there. You know, it was my first casino life. I was there for 2 years. At that time, I was married. My wife takes sick. And I'm like, man, we're still in the house here in Jackson. And so I got to get back home. And God was so fortunate. At that time, it was Isla Capri in Vicksburg. Diamond Jack Casino bought Isla Capri.
Right.
And they were looking for executive chef.
Wow.
I interviewed for it. I got the job, and I showed them what I got. And I turned the buffet around, you know, make something real spectacular.
Hold on, big dog. Hold on one second.
Okay.
Young people, you better get this here. You don't give up. You had a journey.
Yes.
You had a journey until you got to your destination.
Yes.
Till you got to you reach your maximum goal. Young people, you better hear this, man. You tell it to him. Tell it to him. Before you tell him, we're going to go to commercial break. I know I'm standing up. I hope you guys got me. Stay tuned. You don't want to miss this era. Talking fashion and food and journey with my friend, Godfrey Morgan. We'll be back in a minute.
It's almost a consensus that the best wide receiver in football is number 80.
Guys, welcome back to Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and friends. My friend, the chef, the executive chef, the president chef, the queen chef, the king chef, everybody chef, Mr. Godfrey Morgan. Welcome back, my friend.
Thank you.
Man, I'm you know, off the camera, I'm really enjoyed talking with you about your journey. And our young people need to understand the journey and not giving up, the passion of working hard. You know, we don't have to turn to doing negative things. We can stay on that straight and narrow path until we reach our journey. Don't get to the finish line and just stop.
No.
Go through it. Finish the race. And that's what this is about. So continue our conversation with this journey, man. So you had Tunica National, right?
I was in Tunica at the Grand Casino. As I said, at that time, when I was married, my wife took sick. I was trying to get back to Jackson. And the closest I could get was Vicksburg, Mississippi. It was Isla Capri, Diamond Job, Isla Capri. You're looking for executive chef, I'll apply for it. And I get it. And I start to show what I'm make of. You know, just creating different dishes. Just start to attract more people to Diamond Jack Casino. Everyone was going to.
So you were bringing people into the casino.
I was bringing people
based
in.
On your food.
Based on the food, because everybody was going to America at the time. So just trying different thing, not just the same basic casino food. Just put a couple of twists on it.
Let me ask you a quick question before we get back on that topic.
Sure.
If we go to the Kentucky Derby, and they ask you to come and be the executive chef for that day, what would you cook?
Oh, man.
At the Kentucky Derby, the richest of the rich, the you know, well-known of the well-knowns.
For me, a couple of things.
You ain't gonna cook a horse, are you? No, I'm just joking.
A couple of things that I love. I really love oysters. I love fish. Mm-hmm. I love shrimp. I'm a seafood guy.
Well, you come from Jamaica, man. You come from Jamaica, man.
Just preparing it in different ways.
Come on. Right.
You know, coconut and the jerk and mix a little Asian inspiration inside of it.
Wow.
Let's mix it that up. You know, for me, cooking is not just just one thing. You know, I take my knowledge from around the world, you know, Jamaica, American, Asian.
So you're versatile in your cooking and you're choosing up different dishes. Is that correct?
Just like the restaurant right now. Like the restaurant. If you could check, you know, we have sticky ribs, jerk ribs, jerk chicken spring roll.
And don't forget about that mac and cheese, man. We're going to talk about this your menu, because I love the food, man. And I, you know, hey, young people, grown people, you better listen to me. Patronize this man. Don't go in there and give me a free plate. That man got to work. He got a family. You pay for your food.
Yes.
I ain't never went in there and asked for no free food.
Yeah.
I patronize you. Here go my money. I thank you for what you do. My question to you, being in the community of Jackson, Mississippi, in the hood, with your restaurant, what did that mean to you?
First thing first, when I was at Jackson State, I was
I love, baby. Yeah, I love. Oh, D-I Lord. Love. Oh, yes. Just hit me. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
I worked there for about 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
I was living there.
And that's where I met you. You work in the department?
I was over there at the cafeteria.
That's where I first met you.
Yes. I was living in Byram
and
drive up and down Terry Road. You know, every time the interstate busy, you take Terry Road to go to Byram. And there is not much place to eat. Everyone go out north or Flowood to eat. So I say to myself from day one, when every chance and the opportunity to open up a restaurant, I want to put it over here. I want to make a difference over here.
Wait a minute, hold on.
Mm-hmm.
That magic word,
say
it in that camera right there. Say it real loud. You want to do what?
I don't want to make a difference.
You want to make a difference and make it more money? Or you want to make a difference in the community or the people? Or specify yourself, brother.
Make a difference in the community.
That's what I'm talking about.
You know, when I was rebuilding the space, a lot of people called me, what are you doing? Don't over here, you know, just a lot of crime, this, a lot of that. But for me, if somebody don't make a stand, instead of only you have fast food, it's just gonna be the same. So I come on in, I put a really good twist on the menu that we can take care of course, my love, Caribbean. All American, touch of Asian, just a blending pot that everybody is welcome. Not only whites, but black, Chinese.
Everybody.
Everyone is welcome.
And that's how we're gonna make a difference in our community, in our city, in our state, in our world.
Yes.
That we come together on one accord.
On one accord.
No matter what color you are, nationality, we come together. We build. Now we got everybody working together on one accord.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Let me ask you this. In the hood, did that hurt you financially? It's a two-part question, okay? Did it hurt you financially going to an area like that? Hold on. Oh, it's a two-part question.
Okay.
Read that sign up there. Can I keep it real? Won't you keep it real with me?
Keep it real, bud.
Okay.
Yes.
Did it hurt you financially? And secondly, will you move out of the city and go to the suburbs, like a Madison or Flowood or surrounding area?
Well, I'm going to answer backward.
Okay.
The Godfrey's location is moving pretty soon, but it's going to be right in the border of Jackson and Flowood.
Okay, okay. So you're going to be on 25 somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
See, I know that. See, you can't fool me. Yeah. I know where you're going. I keep up with you. You can't fool me. You can't, Mr. Morgan, you can't fool me.
It's for us, we have grown. And
yes.
No, I'm not losing the money. Actually, we have grown tremendously, you know. I take all my saving.
Wait a minute, say it again.
I take all my saving before I open
right
a restaurant.
There.
I take all my saving and I open up Godfrey's on Terry Road.
Everything you had, you put into that restaurant, that location.
Because if you don't believe in what you're doing,
Wait a minute. Say that again. You got to do what?
If you do not believe in what you're doing, you're not going to make a difference. You know, that was it for me.
I can drop the mic and go home. You have to believe.
You have to. And you got to believe in yourself. And for me, I did pray about it. I'll tell you a story. I was leaving the Bahamas. I did a catering there. On my way back from the Bahamas, I was checking my message. I was in Florida, so I'm checking my message. And so many people was if I'm available to do a catering. I was at Jackson State at that time. I make up my mind right there and say, you know what? I'm quitting my job and I'm opening up my own restaurant. That was a Sunday.
Let me put my seatbelt on right now.
That was a
you
Sunday.
You quit your job.
That's what I was thinking.
See, we got a similar story, mm-hmm. but I'll tell you mine later. Go ahead.
Mm-hmm. I quit the job. I said to the person who was waiting at the time, I said, hey, I'm quitting a job. She said, nah. She didn't believe me. Because
She didn't believe me.
No, didn't believe me. Because I just say it off this, just you know, and it's like, yeah, I'll be there at the airport, check the message, and I said, hey, I'm quitting my job, starting my own business. So that was a Sunday. I returned to work that Monday. I sit in my office and I type up my resignation letter, mm-hmm. and I pause. I went home, I pray about it to make sure that God is leading the way.
You did what?
I pray about
that God is doing what?
Leading the way.
That God is doing what?
Leading the way.
Leading.
Yes. Drop it again.
I gotta drop that again, baby. You gotta let God lead the way. Oh!
The guy too.
Oh. I'm sorry. You know, I get geeked up. You watch the other show before the, you know, I'm sorry. Go ahead. Because you hit the nail right on the head.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
I might not be a full Christian and all that.
Ain't about that.
But I
do just
gotta
believe.
In something.
You just gotta believe.
And that was me. You know, so I let her go. I pray about it. I come the next day and I press send.
What a fool. How hard was it for that finger to go to that?
It was real hard.
I know it was hard.
I don't have insurance no more. I don't have a regular paycheck coming no more. I'm not sure what's going
to
happen.
Well, you're preaching to yeah. our young people out there. Come on.
But I was willing to step out on a limb. I step out to the limb when I leave Jamaica with all friends and family around me.
Let me cut you off right there.
Yes.
Was it more difficult mm-hmm. to step out on a limb leaving Jamaica and step out on a limb opening your own business, starting your own business, giving up insurance, giving up a steady paycheck? Which one was more difficult to do?
Leaving the job, opening up your own restaurant.
Wow. Now, my question to you, why? You're leaving all your family, your relatives, your homeland. Why open up a business was more difficult than leaving your home country?
Because back then, I've been here coming up in 20 years. Mm-hmm. Back then, there wasn't much opportunity there. Mm-hmm. Instead of you work in the hotel industry or work on the farm. Or
Back home.
Yeah, you know, I wasn't a computer guy or none of that. Really.
Okay.
So it was an easy decision for me to leave Jamaica to come here because it's, you know, for us in Jamaica, it was like, okay, United States is a land of opportunity.
Okay, hold it. We know, you know, America is a land of opportunity and you know, the freedom and all this stuff here. But we got to go to a commercial break.
Yes.
So guys, stay tuned. Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and friends, and my friend, Mr. Chef himself, Mr. Godfrey Morgan. We'll be back soon.
It's almost a consensus that the best wide receiver in football is number 80.
Welcome back to Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and friends. And my special guest, my friend, the chef of the world, Mr. Godfrey Morgan. Welcome back, my friend.
Thank you, man.
Hey, we're gonna wrap this up, man, mm-hmm. about talking about the transition with your restaurant and the type of food you are serving to your community and what you mean to your community,
yes.
the community of Jackson,
mm-hmm.
and that the South Jackson, is that correct?
Yes.
Is that South Jackson? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Terrible.
Okay. My question to you, you know, this is a talk show about fashion per se.
Yes.
Okay, coming from your country, you know, from Jamaica
mm-hmm.
to America.
Yes.
America. Jamaica. What's the difference in dressing for success in your country, in Jamaica? What you was telling me off the air, something you guys do differently than we kind of do here in America.
Well, we dress a lot, relax, you know, the beach, you know, we wear a lot of t-shirts and, you know.
We got the beach here too. We got a big beach, the Mississippi River. We got the beach, all right. We got the reservoir with gators and everything else in it. Go ahead, I'm sorry.
The first time for me wearing a suit was here, United States.
Really?
Yes.
Wait, hold up. Hold up.
It was a shirt, pants, going out, that's it.
Wait a minute, hold up.
And jeans.
Wow, so mm-hmm. what is the big difference in dressing in Jamaica than in America? I know you talked about you guys love colors.
Oh, we do a lot of bright colors, mm-hmm. you know.
And what do they symbolize?
I think it symbolizes we are just a vibrant people. The reggae music, Bob Marley, just.
Amen!
Buffalo Soldier,
baby. Buffalo Soldier, baby. Godly. Nothing like Bob yes. Marley. Ziggy, mm-hmm. Ziggy.
Ziggy Marley.
Yeah.
So it just symbolizes we are.
Okay.
You know? And for us, you know, dressing, relax every day, and, you know, just mix it up.
Second question.
Mm-hmm.
What do dressing for success mean to you?
You mean as far as for what you do?
Fashion? Because when I come into your restaurant, you mm-hmm. have this nice chef, what you call that? Yeah, I don't want to.
Chef jacket?
Yes. Chef jacket. That thing's sharp, man. That blue one, we got some great pictures together,
yes.
don't we?
Yes, we do.
Man, that's dressing for success based
yes.
on what you do.
Mm-hmm.
So what does dressing for success mean to you as a person, as the owner of a restaurant?
Putting on a jacket every day.
Come on.
It's like putting on a hammer. There's like,
say that again!
I'm ready for whatever the day bring. You know, that jacket, my confidence is up. I'm ready because that's who I am. Chef is who I am every single day. So I put that jacket on, I'm in chef mood.
It does something to you.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Godfrey. It does something. You said you got your body armor on.
I put on body armor.
That can't nobody touch you right now.
No.
I got to do what I got to do.
My hand.
And you put the best of the best on your food every time you put the jacket
yes.
on.
Yes. When I put that jacket on, my aim is to please my customers. That is my aim.
Oh, my goodness.
You know what I mean? Take some of the simplest dishes and make it the most delicious as possible.
Wow.
That is my aim. That is my difference. That is my difference in South Jackson. you know, take a combination of a little bit of what I learn around the world and stuff that I love and put it on a menu right there in South Jackson.
Last question for you.
Yes.
If you had to talk to someone in South Jackson, inner city young black kid, mm-hmm. that's going through some tough times, going through some difficult times, mm-hmm. need a mentor, need somebody to lift him up, mm-hmm. what would you say to that young man? Especially about dressing for mm-hmm. success, how you carry yourself.
Find yourself a passion. Find yourself a passion, something that you can believe in, something that you can get up every day and dressed up for to look forward to. From the simplest to a chef jacket or even up on a short pants, whatever it is.
A police outfit or a fireman outfit, come on.
Whatever it is.
Whatever.
Find yourself a passion. Outfit. You know what I mean?
So that's the key thing is the passion of what you're doing.
Yeah, it can't just be for the money, just to survive. If I was just doing that right there, I'd be closing down the restaurant a long time ago because I'm meeting so many difficulties. You know, everybody who come to the restaurant, you don't know what they're going through. Some folks, you know, they're having a rough day. Somebody just died for them. They're not feeling well. They just have surgery. And they need that
uplifting.
And that's what we do. We supply a service, not yes. only great food. It could just be a simple smile. How are you doing today?
Right.
And
it goes a long way.
It goes a long way. It make a difference. Wow. Or they come and try a piece of sticky ribs and they put a smile on your face.
Wow.
Yes.
Man, mm-hmm. we really appreciate what you're doing in the community. We know the food you have is awesome, but stand up.
Yes, sir.
I love this outfit, man. I love this outfit. You got the bracelets going on, man. You got the vest, the matching tie. I love the jeans. They gotta yes. be True Religion. I know they are.
True Religion, yes.
Also, this man, how many suits I gave you? You bought a suit for me.
Yes.
Let me tell you what this man mm-hmm. did. Okay, what camera I'm at, okay? We was doing a Dress for Success in the Mississippi Delta. Remember that?
Yeah, that.
And I came to Godfrey. I said, mm-hmm. man, we got some kids that we need to do some makeovers and give away some free suits. He said, Bob, what you need? He wrote a check that we can buy at least 3 suits mm-hmm. for these young people. This man did that. He did that. Then he turned around and bought 2 suits from himself.
Yes.
And one was you wanted to give away to one of your workers.
Yes, I did.
This man got a heart of gold. He helped the young people up in the Mississippi Delta, and he gave one of his employees a free suit.
Yeah.
That's what it's all about. But this is what we're gonna do for you.
Okay.
You got a free suit online.
Oh my God.
Only thing you have to do is put together your outfit. The shoes, the socks, the belt, the suit, the shirt, the tie, the pocket square. Okay, guess what you're doing? You're going to speak at a major event, okay?
Uh-huh.
You're going to speak to the top chefs at the White House.
Got you.
At the White House. You're going to mentor them and put your touch on mm-hmm. that menu at the White House.
Mm-hmm.
Are you ready for this? Can you do this?
I was born ready.
Somebody better shut the back door. He said, I was born ready. Let's do this. Let's get the music going. Man, I might not dance on this one. I just might just watch you because you was born to do this. Ready?
Ready?
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Go get your outfit. Go.
All right. Good thing.
When I need motivation, my one solution is my queen, cause she stays strong. Yeah, yeah. She is always in my corner, right there when I wanna. All these other girls are tempting, but I'm empty when you're gone. And they say, do you need me? Do you think I'm pretend? Or I make you feel like cheating? I'm like, no, not really, cause oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need her. Oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need her. She walks like a model. She grants my wishes like a genie in a bottle. Yeah, yeah.
I gotta put that.
And all these other girls are tempting, okay. But I'm empty when you're gone.
Right,
and they
so
say,
gotta get
do you need
sure.
me? Do you sure. think I'm pretend? Or make you feel like cheating? I'm like, no, not really. Cause oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader.
gotta get a pocket square. Yes, yes, yes. Come on.
She gives me love and affection. Baby, did I mention you're the only girl for me? No, I don't need a next girl. Mama loves you too. She thinks I need the right selection. Now all that's left to do is just for me to pop the question. Oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader.
So, I love a good brown shoes, as you can see.
Oh, yes, yes. You bought a pair of brown ones from me.
I did.
I sure did. Brown and black.
Exactly. Yeah. And for me, I love blue, and I love the contrast of the little pink inside of the tie. I basically and it bolded up a little.
Yes.
And just,
yeah, man. Yeah, man.
You know, just me.
Just you. You doing
yeah,
you.
Yeah, just doing me.
You doing you. Going to the White House, speak to the top chef there.
Yeah.
You doing you.
Yes.
I like that. What I want you to do, talk on this camera right here. Ask your social media friends, your family, your Ray Ray, your Nut Nut over in the islands to like what you're doing on your Facebook page. Okay? Do that for me right quick.
Hey, everyone. As you know, I'm Godfrey Morgan. I have a restaurant in Terre Road called Godfrey's. Just come and check me out. Check me out on social media. Inbox me, ask me anything about food. I want to thank you. Thank everyone. So love me in Jackson, and I just want to continue doing it. God bless. Good day.
Absolutely awesome. You don't play golf, do you?
No, I want to one day.
I got you, brother. Hey, guys. Thank you for tuning in. Talking Fashion with Robert Ford and friend. And my friend. Come on over, man. Come on over here. This brother, man, was there for me when I need him.
Yes.
And I always support him. I love him. Find a friend that care about you, that love you, unconditional. Stay tuned. We got more big things to come. But if you don't have that suit, get on your knees, keep praying, and keep it in the fairway. God bless you. We love you. Great job. Great job.